We're going to start our presentation by learning how to say hello in Russian. Everybody, please repeat after me now. Здравствуйте.
Здравствуйте.
Very good. Can you say brrr? Now say здравствуйте.
Здравствуйте.
That's very good. First number of the show today will be dance from Siberia. Siberia is a very big part of Russia. You will see fighting dance of two people from Nanai tribe. Nanai tribe is a very small tribe, only 12,000 people in this tribe. So please enjoy fighting dance of Nanai tribe, or in Russian, Barba Nanaitsa. Thank you very much. Next, we're going to learn how to say yes and no in Russian. To say yes, Russian people say da.
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 And to say no, we say нет.
Нет.
Нет. Next, I would like to show you traditional Russian instrument that is called garmoshka. I bought this garmoshka about 3 years in Moscow. I paid about 500 Russian rubles for this instrument. This garmoshka has two rows of buttons on each side. On the right side with single notes, and on the left side with basses and chords. I'm going to sing for you traditional Russian song that is called Kalinka. This song has two parts, slow part and faster part. Малинка моя, малинка, малинка моя. Thank you very much. Спасибо. Now we're going to learn how to say thank you, and you are welcome in Russian. To say thank you, Russian people say спасибо.
Спасибо.
And to say you're welcome, we say пожалуйста. Next song and dance from very cold place in Russia, on the north, that is called Murmansk. Murmansk is located on the Barents Sea. This is very cold place, especially during the winter time. But during the summer time, it's not that bad. The temperature goes up to 4. You will see our musician and dancer, Nina, dressed into outfit that Russian women in Murmansk used to make for their weddings about 250 years ago. This is the song called Metelica, which means the snow song. Thank you very much. Now we're going to learn how to say hi and bye in Russian. To say hi, Russian people say привет.
Привет.
Привет. And to say bye, we say пока.
Пока.
And if you're talking to your friends or to people that you know really well, you can say пока-пока. Next instrument that we're going to introduce to you is called balalaika. Balalaika is one of the symbols of Russia. This instrument is usually made of a birch tree, the most common tree in Russia. Balalaika has only 3 strings, and the musician that plays the balalaika does not use a pick, plucking the strings of the instrument with the bare fingers. 2 strings are tuned exactly the same, A-A, and 1 string is tuned E. We're going to play for you waltz written by Russian composer Vasily Vasilyevich Andreev. Name of this waltz, Babochka, which means the butterfly. One second. Thank you very much. Now we're going to learn how to say left, right, and ice cream in Russian. To say left, Russian people say налево.
Налево.
Налево. And to say right, you say направо.
Направо.
Направо. And if you want to say ice cream in Russian, you say мороженое.
Мороженое.
Мороженое. Next, I would like to ask you a question. How long do you think it takes to drive from here to Russia? Exactly. You can drive to Russia. It's across the ocean. I usually take airplane from JFK Airport, and it takes me about 8 hours to fly to Moscow, the capital of Russia, where my sister lives. Now, we're going to show you another dance and song from a tribe of people in Russia that is called Tsigani. Here in the United States, they call them Gypsy tribe. Irina will be dressed in the traditional Tsigansky or Gypsy outfit, and I will be singing a Gypsy song that is called Dark Eyes or Ochi Chorni. Ochi Chorni. Очень жгучая и прекрасная, как люблю я вас, как боюсь я вас, значит, люблю вас. Я не добрый час, не любил бы вас, не страдал бы так, прожил жизнь свою. Все мое счастье, как-то белая шутка, взлетает в новом сердце, я без тебя, и забудем с новой шатильности, и в шампанское, и в свою ногу, цыганскую пальцу меня, и не нравишься, да поцелуй меня. To show you a couple of tongue twisters from Russia, and I want you to try to repeat those tongue twisters after me. First tongue twister is about a bird that didn't feel really good. Самый чахлый, самый сухой, самый сдохлый. Next tongue twister about gentleman named Greka. Creator was riding across the river when he saw lobster on the bottom. So he stopped and tried to grab lobster, and lobster suddenly snapped his finger. Ехав грек чи не з'їхав, він відрекав грек, рак сунув грек, руку грек, рак за руку грек, і цап! Next on Twister, about four boys, they were drawing pictures with black ink very precisely. Чечені чорники, чечені чорники, чечені чорники, чечені чорники, чечені чорники, next on Twister, about fishermen that were fishing and exchanging one fish for another. Thank you for trying. And the last tongue twister I'm going to show you is a tongue twister song from south of Russia, from the Don River region. It's a Cossack tongue twister. I'm going to translate this tongue twister for you so you kind of understand Cossack type of humor. Gentleman is singing to his girlfriend, Natalia, you are so beautiful. You have white dress, blue eyes. I'm so much in love with you that I want to kill myself. Then he says, no. Why would I kill myself? It's better if I kill you. Then he's asking his friends, hey, bring me the fork, bring me the knife. I am going to kill Natalia. But the fork is broken, and the knife is bent, and Natalia is going to survive only because of bad quality of Russian silverware. Natalia, 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 Спасибо, thank you very much. Next, we're going to show you another dance selection. This dance is from south of Russia, but this dance is not Russian dance, it's actually Jewish dance. We used to have many Jewish people living in Russia, but most of them right now moved to Brooklyn, New York. Thank you very much. Next, we're going to play for another selection on balalaika and guitar. By the way, the balalaika that Irina is playing was made in St. Petersburg in Russia in 1936. This is a very old balalaika, almost as old as I am. And the guitar that I'm playing was made in China last year. Show you several words written in Russian. The first word is the way to say no. Нет. Нет. See some letters in Russian alphabet, they look like letters in English, but usually they have completely messed up pronunciation. Next word is the way to say yes in Russian. Да. Да. See this letter that looks like A. This is first letter of Russian alphabet, letter A. And this is the word, this is number three in Russian. Three. Three. This is a very nice word. The way to say you're welcome. Пожалуйста. Пожалуйста. This is the way to say bye in Russian. Пока. Пока. And remember, if you're talking to your friends, you just say пока-пока. This is number five in Russian. Пять. Пять. This is the way to say hi. Привет. Привет. This is number two. Два. Два. This is number four. Четыре. Четыре. This is the way to say thank you in Russian. Спасибо. Спасибо. And the last word that I have is the way to say number one in Russian. Один. Один. Russian alphabet has 33 letters. Starts with letter R and ends with letter Я. Would you like to hear Russian alphabet from beginning to the end? No. All right, then we're going to skip that. It doesn't take that long. А то вы гадили, я же жили, и краткое колономел по красоте уходит от себя чешет. Четвертый знак. И мягкий знак. Э, ю, я. Exactly 33 letters of Russian alphabet That is called Cyrillic alphabet. The next dance and song we're going to show you is a traditional Ukrainian song and dance that is called Pitmanula. And please check out Irina's outfit. She's going to be dressed as a Ukrainian lady. She's going to be singing a little bit in Ukrainian now.